Stadium. Three more games of Carolina Panthers franchise where we're taking on the Tampa Bay Bucks as well as the Miami Dolphins. In this video, if you guys are new here, my name is Jim King Fan, and this is my YouTube channel. I do my own rebuilds, my own content, and roster updates, and even NBA 2K roster updates. I am the GTO content, number six siege, and other games as well. I basically play whatever I want, whenever I want, and if I feel like recording it, I will. I would like to do some other stuff here in the future, and as I do with some scripts that I am working on for some videos. I have a script about a Chicago Bears running back that I just forgot about. I have a SBM skill-based matchmaking video that I hope to produce soon, and a Chicago Bears video that I want to produce as well. I have other videos as well that I have in my mind that I just haven't decided whether or not I want to make them, or people would even want to watch that content. If you guys like this content, it's easy to subscribe, and it costs you nothing in order to unsubscribe later. We're in season 2, this is episode 15 overall, but this is season 2, episode number 4 of season 2. Okay. I was like, So, if you guys want to stick around for more content like this, or other content in general, whether you're subscribing for roster updates, Panthers franchise mode, Washington 20-year rebuild, or even just fantasy rebuild in general, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on that bell if you really want to get updated every time I post, if YouTube will let you. As we do end up scoring with Christian McCaffrey game. So far this series has been really fun, and I've actually enjoyed playing Madden games, not just because I'm winning, but just for the simple fact that, like, I didn't make the final so difficult and so hard where it's either you butt fuck the CPU or the CPU butt fucks you. Last year I made it way too hard to where I was getting, like, absolutely destroyed, or I was absolutely on fire and looking incredible for it. And I think that was my biggest thing. I was making it too hard. Not like too hard, but like, it just seemed like it was one side or the other. It was either a blowout either way.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
And the team coming around nicely. And last video, Sidney Jones went off 5 interceptions in 2 games, which was incredible. Granted, a couple of them were just like shit throws that, like, especially all the Cowboys ones. All the Cowboys ones were just like shit throws by Dak, and Sidney Jones just went and got them. So, but, you know, a pick's a pick. You know, you, just like I've always said, you have to play the people in front of you, you have to face the people in front of you, you have to make the most out of your situation. Sidney Jones has. And, you know, because we re-signed him. The price that we paid for him was very, very intense. Under around $5 million a year to come in and play for us. And it fortunately gives us a good slot corner in Sidney Jones. I like Sidney Jones since he was drafted by the Eagles. I thought he was good. And, fortunately, we signed this franchise before he got the star. Or we would have had to get that back. Tampa Bay. Did we win both our... No, we got... maybe we did win both our... I'm not 100% sure. But we're taking on Tampa Bay again. Tom Brady's still here. Still going to be a difficult challenge for teams that don't know how to destroy offenses. We have to be careful and we have to put a point where we can. Christian McCaffrey is our leading guy. He's just a dominant player. If you guys did not know why I picked the Panthers, it was because their O-line was basically depleted. Their tight end group was abysmal at best. QB was still a question mark. Teddy Bridgewater and Will Levis and that he's not an absolute question mark, but, like, yeah, he could get better, but he's good. I don't know about for the money, because I've never looked at his contract, but running back is a set position. I think they are very well off there, and running back is going to replace the position. But, and Mike Davis has proven that he's decent, even after disappearing on the Bears. He disappeared for, like, 3 weeks, and nobody even knew what he was up to. Megan scored 19-6, 20-6, actually. Probably be the score after the PAT. Coleman Bowen gets another rushing touchdown on the season. He has not played bad enough to get replaced yet, so. Sorry, I was just looking at my arm. third quarter. Now coming to 6 year, finding Preston Williams across the middle.
Big body down.
Still have to decide whether or not we want to trade him. He's had a pretty hell of a year, pretty good hell of a year, but, you know, can he play like this all the time? We've seen him have the drops. We've seen him have those problems that maybe one of the other guys on our depth chart wouldn't have. So it's kind of in that weird situation of, can we trust him enough and can we get in this contract and hope that he continues to get better, or is this as good as he's going to get? And that's a decision we're going to have to make within the next 2 seasons, within the next 3 weeks. If this was week six, this game was? No. Maybe. Because we played, what, four games? So if we played four games, then this would be week five. So, whatever.
McDonald's so.
And you'll see at the end of the video what we decided to do. Because I did end up making a decision. Because I'm pretty sure we were at week 8 and I had to make a decision. And I ended up making it. Because whatever. Needed more with a good catch after 35 tries. Coming in traffic. Up 23-6 now here in the fourth. 8 minutes left. And Derek is performing. We'll get a catch. Of the day for Derek Brown. Probably like the first sack of the year. And we'll take it and get up the field, up to the 31-yard line of the Buccaneers territory. Throwing it to McCaffrey over there on the sideline, up to the 18-yard line. Carry up to the line, and I ended up pushing from the goal. This is fun. Tom Brady now. He hasn't done anything all game. He's only scored 2 field goals, so he hasn't even scored the kicker has. I mean, like, he's out of range, but you know what I mean. See if we can hopefully stop him and make sure that we win this game and have a good rest of the episode. Gonna run a little spacing thing here, and Sidney Jones will go up and get another pick. I think that's his 6th or 7th of the year. No offense at this trajectory, he will easily have like 12 picks by the end of the year, beating out Night Train Lane, 11 picks on a season. So we end up throwing a pick right back to them. Doesn't make any difference. Don Ross is going to go come back and come get the football. 3 minutes left here in the fourth. This was one of the quicker games because there wasn't just a whole ton of big plays. Like, it was just slow marching drives. And I ended up going, ah, fuck this. Mike Evans is fucking way too hard. I decided I'm switching on to whoever's guarding him, and we're going to play this. And I actually ended up trying to, like, bait Tom Brady. Like, come on, throw my fucking leg. Ended up running over here, and Isaiah Simmons will go up and get the football. 6'4", monster. So I think everybody on my defense is that group. Actually, Dante Jackson. Sure. I'm pretty sure they're going to have a pick.
Second and six.
So I'm pretty sure everybody besides our leading interceptions, the NFL leader in interceptions last year, doesn't have to. Everybody else does, honestly. But maybe because that's not because they're not throwing his way, or he's just not getting in a good position. But then again, he had a slow start last year too. I think. I don't think he ended up getting a pick until like week 4. So keep that in mind. He might just be on a slow starter. So come on, make this guy miss. Missing. Moving, I would have loved to get him in the end zone. It would have been an awesome fucking play. But with 7 seconds left, let's try to get another touchdown or even just another point. Motion the wide receiver out. Come on, make one man miss. Getting into the end zone, 2 seconds left. Good job, McCaffrey. 2 seconds left. I just wanted to try to get another pick. So instead, Mike Evans goes up, gets it, brings it in per game. Just snap padding at that point. I mean, granted, I was trying to stat pad too. I'm not gonna like sit here and judge. I'm not gonna be like, yeah, you're stat padding. No, I'm not, because I did it too. So it's not that big of a deal. If you want to stat pad, you can. And the rush attack got going, and we ended up winning. And I think they led in the turnover battle because I think I don't fucking know. I didn't see. I didn't really care all that much. So.
He was covered by Dante
here against the Dolphins, Tua will be playing here. And if you are in real life, then Tua, I think, is going to start his first game. Well, he already did start his first game, didn't he?
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure how he performed. I'll probably look at it. Play-action fake here, looking at finding Candy across the middle. They're just going to vacate that middle part of the field. I'll take advantage of it. Dropping back to pass, trying to find somebody. Play-action. Not play-action. Going to pump fake and find DJ Moore on the sideline. Going to pump fake him and through to him because, you know. Dropping back to pass, and they just keep leaving that middle part of the field open. We're just going to keep going with it because why not? There's no point in just sitting here not taking advantage of those situations that we are put in. We get the ball back after three and out from them, giving it to Campbell. I thought I could make Kyle Van Noy miss. Apparently not. Oh, that's good.
A loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the 17 yard line.
Dropping back to pass. They're going to find Devontae Parker. Haven't heard much of him so far this year. Tim Mike Gesicki's having a really good year as well. The Dolphins team still doesn't look great on paper. If you really look at it, it's Matt Breida and Dylan Powers. Magic, Tua, Devontae Parker, Preston Williams is a Magic team brand. Their team's just still not great on paper. Their line's not great on paper. None of the team is really great on paper. So, them playing good is very surprising, especially after they traded, Roquan McMillan. John Baker's the main linebacker now. I don't know who's playing alongside of them, but Denny Jones, go down there and get this. Denny Jones is a fucking beast. He's been playing absolutely out of his goddamn mind. He has no reason to be this good right now, and he is. Don't know who number 85 is, but Brown. John Brown. He's covering Gesicki and Brian Burns will get hurt. Cutting from that right side for some reason. Or maybe he came around in a weird angle. Trying to find somebody. R1 was open and I was so mad when I saw this play earlier. I was like, you gotta be fucking with me. R1 was wide open. No. This play I didn't remember before I even played it. Because I was like trying to get R1 to like stay there and he moved and I was about to throw it and I was so mad. So. Tugga Vailoa. Gonna scramble with Coleman Donald. This was a game where I kept scrambling with Coleman Donald and I just kept finding wide open gaps. I don't know if it's because the Miami defense is in the wrong scheme and like they just can't cover me as well or what. Gonna find Oga Howard down in the middle of the field here, getting all the way down to the 3 yard line, call a timeout. Let's get some more points on the board. Ended up scoring here with Preston on the field. A good jump ball, and he won't bring out of it. So on two vent, let's try to get a pick here. They end up throwing short for 50, 50 from 15 yards here. Top on his back, make him go down to the ground.
That's a gain of three. It's third and 7.
Give it to Campbell. Campbell's going to run along the sideline. Trying to just not run people. Get up all the way to the 42-yard line of our own side after a stuffed play. They're going to sack us. Coleman Downs going to kick the ball, and they're going to pick it up and take it into the end zone.
Touchdown, Miami.
Oh, wait. Has Miami not? Oh, yeah. Miami's going to buy. They got a buy this weekend. Never mind. I don't know what I thought they played this weekend. But you know, my Bears just got crushed. I knew we were bad. And I knew we were always bad. Matt Nagy and Ryan Casey are fucking
awesome.
That's for a different video. If I had decided to make it. If I'm still feeling angry as shit. This pass was forced to Marcus Williams. Just jumps in. Simple as that. You know, if they got Marcus Williams in real life, that would be a good. They would have Marcus Williams, that's with Davian Howard, and who's the guy that just came from the Cowboys, Byron Jones. They'd have to draft somebody at strong safety. You can't pay four guys on the back. So then you're going to have no money for that upside. And I still don't think their pass coverage situation, their linebacker situation, or their pass rush situation has been solved yet either. Granted, like I said, I don't like to mind your team on paper. But they've been playing well. If they want to play hard, and if they play well, and if they draft well, you know, we'll lie at them, so we'll lie at them, right? I'm just a kid on the internet, so. Most people will put it anyway. McCaffrey on that little corner route, picking up a good chunk of yards. After two plays of not going anywhere, going to find Preston Williams. He was getting three touchdowns. And he made it so hard. I'm just like, God damn it. Now I don't have a question. Really crazy. And going to put this out there. Jordan Howard takes it to the end zone. I miss Jordan Howard. Oh my god, I miss Jordan Howard. Great job. Pain me when we fucking traded him. No reason to trade him. I almost get there with the two of those models, man. CJ Day, you gotta cover that a little bit better, dude. Like, I had excellent pass rush and I was into his face and he didn't throw a great ball. Now you can't even get him. And Cameron Belage is the receiving back on 90%. Like, no. Let's not put, like, Matt Breida out there if we still have him. Or one of these guys. Let's put Kalen Ballard. Kalen Ballard be our receiver. Whatever they want to do, they can do. 26-14, 3 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Mike Zicky finds another catch here. 4th and 6. This could be the determining factor of the game. That's in a little bit of pressure here. And pass. They're going to get it. Lonzo Parker goes up and gets it. They're going to cut him down with the leg though. 2 minute warning here. Minute 53 now. Left. 4th and 10. Another 4th down situation. Trying to find Parker. Finds him again. You've got to be kidding me. Covering again. Trying to find somebody in CGJ. Let's go. Good pick on him. Comes up clutch. He was getting torched a lot of the game, and I was really happy when he came up with that clutch pick. And I was, like, really happy, and I was like, good job, TJ, you want to see this? And I was like, wait a second, you fucking got burned up wrong. Like, it's kind of like that thing, like, if even if a kicker goes 5-for-5 in the beginning of the game, scoring 15 of your points for an offense, and then misses the game-winning field goal, you're still going to blame the kicker. But if he misses the first 5 earlier and then hits the game winner, you're going to love him. Type of situation. And then we ended up trading Njoku. I just didn't use him. Irving is too good, and OJ just kept proving himself, so we ended up trading for Ross Blacklock. BJ Hill and Preston Williams for Kyle Duggar, Chase Winovic, and JC Jackson. Getting absolutely weird in here. Marcel Darius for Terrell Burgess. I don't know what I'm going to do with all these players. I just started trading people, and then once I got everybody, I'm like, I don't know what the fuck I'm going to do with all these people. Trubisky and for Claypool and Jalen Samuels. Jalen Samuels will just be another fullback tight end situation. Philip Lindsay and Cravon LeBlanc for Hassan Reddick. Lindsay was never going to get any touches on this team. But like I said earlier, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff. I gave Damon Arnett to the Chiefs, and then I gave somebody else to somebody. I gave... Who the fuck was it? Come on, show the clip. Then I gave 3 picks for Dalton Schultz. But like I said, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Turn on post notifications. I'll see you guys in the next video. Go follow on Twitch for some live fun. I'm hopefully going to be streaming here soon. I have been trying to get streaming done. But with that being said, I'm out. Peace.